Now,
yes, you may.
In a world that Badger lives for a scratch and sniff dick, what the fuck?
title of the show, Scratch and Sniff Dick.
I like that. We're going to let this play just a little bit just to start the flavor for the room.
Start the aroma.
The dick cheese aroma. So do you like that smell of dick cheese?
No.
Dude, that shit's horrible.
She wishes that was a dressing.
Like blue cheese?
Wait. Okay, I think we have to start. Hold on.
Uncircumcised guy thing anyway. You know what I mean?
Wait. So you live for the smell of dick? You really do like that? Totally about that?
Well, not necessarily the smell, but like the taste, for sure.
The aroma.
The tender touch.
The je ne sais quoi?
Kinda.
Oh, mon chéri.
How else do you explain it?
It's unexplainable. Hence.
God damn, dude. So what? Have you ever come across like big amounts of, or even like small amounts of dick cheese on any of the dicks in your adventure in your life?
What the fuck?
That's when I stop.
That's when you stop?
Yeah.
So you have come across it?
Yeah.
Like, are you storing for the winter, or is that what's going on? What the fuck?
Is ranch to blue cheese as come to dick cheese?
Oh, wow. That's a big fucking spectrum to cover. First of all, no one likes blue cheese. If you're a blue cheese...
I love blue cheese.
If you... Okay. Whoa. If you love blue cheese, you're a fucking faggot. Okay.
Wait a fucking minute.
You're a fucking faggot.
I'm a fucking faggot.
I thought it was a white people thing. You know, I thought only white people were into blue cheese.
That's right.
I
thought so too.
I've been into blue cheese.
You know what?
Really?
You know what?
I don't know. I don't get it.
I got one thing.
My credit score went up a little bit.
What?
That's what it is. I'm still fucking around with Thousand Islands, man.
Damn.
You gotta get with the times, bro.
My shit's hood.
You gotta get with the times.
I hood up my salad with Thousand Islands.
Dude, your
shout out to Tams.
Your dressing game is low, kid.
Way low. Way fucking low.
All right, well, the best way to start this show off was Badger dick cheese and dick sniffing. That's what I'm talking about. Pigs is back. It's been a while.
People, let me tell you about my best friend. He's a warm-hearted person who loved me till the end.
You're listening to Pigs Radio, broadcasting live from a secret location in Compton, California. The talk show that makes psychiatrists see other psychiatrists. Other psychiatrists. Other psychiatrists. Other psychiatrists.
Other psychiatrists. Pigs Radio episode 185.
No,
86.
I swear we are stuck in sixes. Every time we have a show, it's something with a six. I feel like it should be 169, but...
Oh, that's...
You just want 169 to smoke some more dick. That's what you want.
Wait, didn't you do 169?
That was her birthday. She just... God damn it. No one cares about your
birthday. I just celebrated another birthday.
Nigga, that was months ago.
What birthday?
A half birthday.
Like when they pop your cherry or some shit or what?
Oh, dude, she hasn't had a cherry since she was five.
That's what I mean. Hey. She celebrated the anniversary.
She had one last night on my topping.
Oh. Damn.
Maybe I did.
I got you, girl. Don't trip.
What's up?
There goes one up. Not even talking about shrooms either.
Oh, Badger, god damn it.
Sorry.
As always, I'm Mario81 with Sexy Ankles, and I am now officially been an international man. I just came back.
Is that your first time?
That was your first time.
First time ever leaving the country.
Dude, what? You went to Mexico. That's not international.
Hey, not the fuck where you were born, not TJ. Like Mexico City. Real shit. Real shit.
All right. I don't know that place.
You know he was so fucking scared.
Yahweh.
Did you run into a chupacabra or any of that shit?
I was looking for chupacabras and witch doctors and I don't know.
You should have been searching for El Chapo.
You know what? There were wanted posters everywhere, but something I didn't want to get involved with.
Dude, you know, stay away from that.
He was hiding behind the poster.
I really was. But I will say, it is weird to go to a place with nothing but Mexicans and no one is cutting lawns or fucking selling me oranges or roses. Fucking weird. They have regular jobs out there.
Because in Mexico, everything is peaceful. Like, even though they could be, like, in poverty, like, it's peaceful. Everybody's just chill. Like, fuck it.
It's just kind of weird not to see all the white people in charge. You know? It's all fucking Mexicans.
How'd you do with your Cuban accent, though?
My Cuban accent? I spoke very little, so they wouldn't think that I was white or anything. I was
or overcharge you?
Or overcharge me. I was super scared of being abducted and getting more fingers cut off. I kept in contact with
you
the States.
You should have got your fucking finger sewed back on while you
I don't
were out
have
there.
It anymore.
Yeah, dude, that shit would have been so cheap, dude. They would have had like fucking add like a little nub into or add to your nub.
Something just dangly there.
And they would have given you Xanax after.
Right?
It's the same guy that writes the names on a piece of rice.
Oh shit. Hey, I remember those motherfuckers too. That shit was long. I had one. I'm not gonna lie.
You still have it.
You know what? I might. Dude.
I think you do. In the outskirts, maybe.
The Badlands.
Hey, don't.
And always right. Talking about the outskirts of her fucking vagina.
Very skirty.
Outskirty.
How meaty is it?
Outskirt.
Don't act like you
is
don't
it
know.
An outskirt?
Oh. The ones that look like they're throwing up gang signs. Blah.
So it's like you sandwiched down there, dude.
That's why I can't eat the hat no more.
Do you have like curtains or like mini blinds?
Oh,
are
shit.
They beef curtains?
You
or
know what?
Or are they just shutters?
It is actually, from what I've seen, like I see, hear you guys talking, so I look at other pictures, and my shit is beautiful. I'll send you a picture later.
Oh, shit.
Another one.
Yeah.
Underdog, you got my number, right?
So, wait. So,
I'll send a group chat later. No, group.
So it's official. You guys are fucking now.
Wait, nah. What?
It's official.
No,
not
yet. No, it's not.
Not
wait,
yet.
We got a couple more hours.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
The night is still young, is what you're saying.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
called
yeah.
Make
we
love.
Got a few. Ooh.
I make love.
Oh shit.
Don't you like
this fool?
Fucking throwing in the mojos already
for the first time ever. Being.
I just watch it, baby.
I know it's Sunday, but it's not the other mojo, show, homie.
For the first time ever being desired for love, let's give it up for the one and only Badger.
Badger!
Badger has fucking meat curtains for vagina!
Sticky puss!
Jalapeno nipples!
That even hurt me, homie.
That's the only truth in this room!
That was the only truth out of all the shit that we
yeah.
did.
Yeah.
Wait, I missed it. What's the truth?
What?
The jalapeno nipples.
Who has jalapeno nipples? Now, Fix does have pepperoni nipples.
I do have pepperoni.
They are disgusting. They look like something right off of Domino's pizza.
Nipples, bro.
What?
Beautiful nipples, bro.
It looks like a Big and Tasty from the fucking Caesars.
That's really gross.
Colossal burger.
You do have like fucking $5 grab and go nipples. They are just fucking, they're ridiculous. They're even Badger doesn't have nipples like that.
This fool has no rules.
Can we see?
No.
You have to be there at the second annual Cyclone.
That's no, wait.
No, wait.
What? Or the first annual? Second annual.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
That's the first time Badger just let her tits out in fucking public. Well, not in public, but in front of the psycho kids.
Yeah.
Cheap bastards.
That didn't even happen, though.
Totally happened. Shout out at Cesar Tijeras at 1246 Barbershop.
Straight up, my nigga.
Oh, that was the first time.
Turn up, son.
Yeah, no. No. They were covered.
They were X'd out. They looked like fucking... Okay, so you know when you like knock out a cartoon character and he gets X's on his eyes? Yeah. That's what she had on her nipples, and we don't
He's
know right why.
You can knock me out any day.
So it was planned, right? That must have been planned if he had the shit on your nipples.
Nothing
right?
was planned because she had never met this guy. This guy just whips him out. And according to her, she doesn't recall why or even how she
Look,
even got black tape on her nipples.
Oh, for some on. Reason, you told come me on. To be there at like 10 o'clock in the morning. And guess what? Bloody Mary's from 10 o'clock in the morning. We were fucked up. I don't know what was going on.
Wait, so, okay. So you
sacrifice.
So, you didn't show up with tape to the Cyclone.
No.
But while you were there and you got drunk, you end up getting tape on your nipples at the Cyclone.
And knowing you, Mario, you probably have tape on you all the time.
It's covering my asshole.
You know what?
Lie.
Come to think of it, it probably was your tape.
I don't have black tape like that.
All
I do.
I don't carry it.
Was it with you that I got the black tape?
No, but you know what? I wish somebody would have told me, man.
I know. Where's the invite?
I want to tape you like a fucking mummy and shit, to be honest with you.
I just, for the nipples.
I'm into that.
Damn it.
You're into mummified?
I'm mummified. You know, I love latex and shit.
We can do put the tape on the badger. It's like it's a party or something.
I like latex, but not on my penis. Just.
Oh, okay.
I go the Lord's way. Yeah. I go raw.
You raw dog that shit, bro?
I raw dog all the time.
I don't know, dude. Yeah. You know, we're going to change the name from underdog
kids
straight
out,
back
style.
Kids out there, make sure you practice safe sex, all right?
God damn.
Unless it's with Diego, in that case, he's Rod Dog.
Yeah, unless it's me, baby, because you know I got you.
Yeah, son. Catch that herpes, son.
Maybe it's because it's too veiny, you know? It doesn't fit.
How do you know?
He said.
Oh, okay.
No, I think that was him.
I said that.
He's a veiny ass nigga.
Getting the dicks mixed up.
Now, and speaking of the cyclone, we have the very one and only, very niggiest, mysterious niggas of all of them. Mystery nigga.
I try. I try to keep some anonymity because I don't want to get locked up. So what's up, everybody?
Fucking Warrens, kid.
Now, the Cyclone is Mystery Niggas, babies. He's been doing this for quite some time. This is now going to be the fourth annual?
Yes.
Fourth annual Cyclone happening at the Long Beach Seaport Marina.
Hotel, casino, or jacuzzi and spa. I don't know. No, they don't have none of that shit.
Oh, okay. Come on, man. This place is really fucking whack.
It's a fucking rundown motel that's fucking stupid enough to let us do a fucking show there.
Yeah.
That's fucking suckers.
That's punk rock, bro.
That's always the fun places, you know?
You know what, bro? I'm going to have to agree with him because one year my fucking room didn't even have AC.
Oh, hell no. So your room has AC, right?
Yeah.
The badger needs to cool off.
Yeah, I got the suite. Come on, man.
The badger needs to cool the fuck off.
Yeah, fucking, I got two skinny dip.
Now, they conned us this year into going back into the Cyclone after we were banned because apparently we're too racist.
We probably begged.
No, we didn't. I denied last year's invitation, and I denied this year's, but we got conned into going this year. We are broadcasting live from Mystery Nigga's room.
That's right.
We're going to be closet cases for the weekend, but guess what? We're inviting at least 3,000 people to the room.
I'm going to be recruiting.
Yeah. 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 So we're it's going
to
go down this year.
I actually have to sleep in there, dick. You can't do that.
You can sleep at the end of the night. We're going to be gone by the end.
It's Sunday.
Well, like
it's Sunday too, bro.
Yeah.
Bro. So imagine Coachella, but in Long Beach and with fucking dirty psycho kids.
In my room?
Yeah.
There is no end of
the
night.
I'm
going to
give you fucking Brando's room key. You guys can go in there, dude.
We don't have the denim suite.
Fucking denim.
It's all padded in denim.
denim comforter. Denim sheets.
Denim pillowcases.
Shower curtains.
Denim beanbag.
Now, over the last year, we have learned. We have learned that Brando from Von Vadsville Entertainment is the king of denim. Word on the street is that even fucking Jay Leno buys denim from him. That's just the word on the street. He is the capital kingpin of denim. So. He's also your counterpart in the Cyclone, so yes, we expect to see him in a lovely decor of different shades of denim.
He's
gonna be a fucking walking rainbow with denim, you know what I mean?
Now,
from indigo blue to light blue, stonewash blue.
Arctic
blue. It's all navy blue.
I do remember from the last Cyclone we were at, right before we got banned, that he had this crazy ensemble of denim. It was a different color denim pants, a denim cutoff vest, and he had a denim fucking sailor hat.
He did. He was stacked with denim.
Now that okay, so
denim creepers too.
Does he have like denim dollars? Is that how he? Does he have his own currency now?
Is that on his like Christmas wish list? Like
denim
I want denim dollars.
Denim dollars.
His fucking nickels say Levi's.
So we can't party in that room because it's full of denim. Because we're going to be selling denim.
All right.
Brando Von Vadsville embroidered denim at the fourth annual Long Beach Cyclone, which is happening on Thursday, apparently Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
That's right.
It is now four days of clusterfuck and bro kids. It's going to be great.
Yeah, it's going to
be the Badger.
Disaster.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm going to be all over that motherfucker. Right.
Badger's going to be there in all her glory, legs spread open across the fucking
glory hole.
So we plan to start drinking as soon as we get there and then kind of go from there.
That's more like a well.
Underdog, are you joining us that day after all?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, cool.
I'll let you know the day before.
Yeah, he's not going to
Why?
He's not going to go.
Well, what had happened was he had heard that there's already the fucking the new Star Wars land in development, so he's going to go start waiting in line for
it. It's going to be like 5 years at least before they even...
2017.
That's so sad.
So serious.
So sad.
Get it right, all right.
So sad.
Dude, tell me you're not going to go to fucking Disneyland on Labor Day weekend, man. That's a tourist trap, dude. Come on.
He doesn't give a fuck. He's like fast pass all day.
He's what, like, I ain't no tourist. I earn these stripes and this fucking vest I have from Main Street Elite.
Yeah, he's so got a vest.
I'm prospecting right now.
You know how fucking weird you say that? We actually have our prospect in the building. We have Fix, who's prospecting for Pigs Radio right now. He's the Pigs prospect.
Oh, what? He's the prospect.
Want to jump him in or what?
We don't give denim, just to let you know. We don't give patches. We just... You just hang out with us and drink and fuck.
Here you go. You've been pinned.
You get
there
pins.
You go.
And you get a and you get an honorary dick suck at the end of the night by Badger.
Huh? Yeah.
I'm in.
Yeah, I thought it was two. We all got one on the way in, dude. You didn't get one?
Those are complimentary, too.
Yeah.
You get tokens and shit? Or
a pin and a blowy.
Are these valid for anything at Nickel Nickel?
If you get one more, you get to see nipples.
Oh.
You know. Oh, okay. You
gotta catch them all.
I can't talk about this.
Now, if you want to see, if you want to see the Badger's nipples at this year's Cyclone, you can give us a call at 909-475-7449. We'll take a guest list, and then there'll be free
I'm gonna
flashing.
Have denim X's on my nipples this year.
I'll go on to
Bob. I want to fit in.
So, what's up, Mr. Nigga? Can we give away a free pair of tickets?
Yes, we can, but
tonight?
Not tonight.
What the fuck? Why are you being cheap?
I got here for next week.
Okay, you know what? You know what? If we had Brandon on here, we'll be giving away the kitchen sink at the Cyclone.
You'd be giving next year's fucking show passes away.
You will win a lifetime pass
to the
Cyclone.
Didn't that happen last year? Wasn't it?
Yeah, there
like
was a...
Every event in the future that I exist with.
Really?
Come on down. No, it was pretty intense.
Yeah, that was...
Yeah, no.
Free denim for life.
You're the Jew in the relationship.
That's right. Somebody's got to watch the fucking... It ends, fool. We got paid people at the end of the night, dude.
All right. So, once again, we have Fix from Scallywag Entertainment. I know, this year, are you hosting any backyard garbage pail party?
Outskirt events.
The logistics of it hasn't been worked out, but...
we're still up in the air with the pool party thing right now.
Fool, you invite me like a week after. I look at my messages. I'm like, I'll take it away later. Yeah, you are, fool. That would be cool.
I don't know what happened there. I was
What happened was.
He forgot to push send.
Explain yourself.
Sometimes it just doesn't go through, man. What can I say?
You forgot to hit send.
Okay, so if nothing's been confirmed, how do you have logistics?
Well, we don't know what's going to happen. Told me if I was going to do it or not.
It's like next week, guys.
I know.
What the fuck?
Welcome to the Cyclone. Exactly.
Exactly. All I know is that I'm showing up and fuck it. Whatever happens.
All I know is, Badger, the last Cyclones we were a part of, we made sure everything was on point on the pig side.
Sure was. In our drunk ass minds,
yeah.
It was.
Hell yeah, it was.
That's what I was gonna say.
Pig style.
This one was passed out on the stage and shit.
Hey, I was pigs wasted and I did a fucking pig's job.
At least when I black out, I'm still partying.
Now, that year, Pigs Radio got pigs wasted. Oh. We started drinking at 10 in the morning to fucking 2 weeks later. It was gross.
It was.
I passed out a few times.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. You really do feel gross leaving that fucking place at the end of the fucking week.
Because it's so Long Beach or because of the Cyclone?
The whole fucking deal, bro.
Everything. It's just scuzzy, dude.
I'm tired and just fucking, they smell like booze. It's like the whole fucking thing.
Booze is the least of your worries to smell like.
Yeah, I compare it to like when you go to Viva Las Vegas and shit, you come back, you're all beat to shit, you know? So, yeah. Pretty much the same thing. It's 4 days of fucking getting all fucked up.
Wait, so you're comparing your show to Viva Las Vegas show?
I know.
Like, wait a minute. Wait.
Well, when I leave exhausted from that motherfucker, yeah, dude, I say it's
so you're comparing it to the tiredness of Viva, but the show is not like Viva.
No, of course not. That's
okay.
Been
just making sure.
Fuck Viva. Fuck you, Viva.
Because I feel like we're at Coachella right now.
I would compare it to...
Yeah, I'm waiting for Rick D's to walk in right now.
Awkward. So, if you want... once again, it's going to be on Labor Day weekend, September...
3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th.
At the Long Beach Seaport Marina.
Hotel.
You guys like young kids, no money, stinky people... A lot of booze. Sailor Jerry's going to be there.
Ton of booze.
I'm a cougar in training, though.
Hey, what's up with that coconut water again this year? Is it going to happen?
You know what? We haven't approached them, and they haven't approached us. I don't know, dude. A lot of people...
3 weeks away, and so haven't approached certain people.
I heard a lot of people got the runs from drinking way too much coconut water.
You know what?
That's probably a cleanser.
Mexico water.
I didn't learn about coconut water till Viva Las Vegas. That was the first time like someone brought it into the room like, okay, fucking Satoki.
Were you just comparing?
No, I'm just saying. No.
Hey, you know what? This might be a surprise, guys, but they sell coconut water everywhere.
I know, but I never heard about it until it was like a punk rock, like cycle, rockabilly shit, you know?
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Satoki brought it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sackabillies discover coconut
so,
water.
Apparently so. No, like, well, I can see why it's a trend or why it would be a good idea to bring a coconut water sponsor.
Actually, it is really good, like, if you're really dehydrated, like, bullshit aside, because, you know, I did go to EDC, and that's even more extreme, you know what I mean? And, you know, being in the hot extreme weather.
They sell coconut-infused LSD. That's what they got.
On I was trying to put it in the, you know.
Straight candy flipping and shit with some coconut water.
So all right, so.
And tasties.
So, in the show, I'm sure you guys heard, we have a fucking gangster-ass chola in here. This is actually not a personality. This is a real fucking legitimate person. The inside inner white boy in me is really scared, and I already locked away my car. Really scared of my wallet. But the Mexican in me is super excited because I feel like I'm going to get tatted tonight and jumped into some gang.
You ain't down.
No, you just totally look like a hit. You just look like a hit.
I'm totally not down.
Do you have a butterfly knife on you right now?
Nah,
is it in your do?
Totally. That's right there. That's Choco! You don't really bust out the fucking filero right now.
Hey, Washa? Shoulder?
All right, my dear, please let us know who you are.
What's up, everybody? First of all, thank you for having me here. Thanks, Badger. You know, she's making my pins right now. So. And it's pretty good to see everybody else here. Anyways, I'm LA Casualty, also known as Madam Morticia. And I'm here based on LA and shit. So, yeah.
Okay, let the questions go, because I'm sure there's a 10,000 questions.
A million questions.
Okay, so I've known her for years.
I am not a man.
She is not a man. Not a man. She has tits and probably a vagina. Either that or it's tucked really good. I'm not sure. So we recently found out that you have a long list of jobs.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so you're a female MC.
Yes, I'm a female MC. I also do a lot of different entertainment. And
What kind of entertainment? Are you a stripper? Yeah.
No, I'm burlesque.
Prostitute. Oh, okay, burlesque.
Yeah.
Oh.
I do burlesque in the style of, as I keep it, you know, keep it, like, within my raza and everything. I keep it pachuco style. So I do the mambo, you know? That's my shit, yeah.
Mambo number 5?
No, probably not that
number
mambo.
Like,
one, two, three, four, five.
That's like the whitest mambo thing I ever heard in my life, dude.
Oh, my God.
No, but I also do also different projects, like when my girls Chola Pinup, they are internationally, like, spreading and everything pretty good. You know, they look at people like us, you know, as Hispanics and everything. They look down, talk shit, and be like, oh, you know, this is good for nothing. But in what we're trying to do is, you know, change that. We do help charities, children, people in jail. We even get pen pals for the motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? We
look like Cholas. You guys probably like ex-girlfriends.
Nah, Cholas, we're going to go way back.
What's the craziest picture you ever sent to somebody?
Craziest
picture? In the pen?
As
a pen pal.
It was probably fucking Jose.
to be honest with you, I don't send
thankfully
pictures.
Thankfully, I never did state time, man. I only did county. So
Shout out to all the pee-pee makers out there.
Yeah. It's all the homies, dude.
Shit, my fan would be like, shout out to all them spread makers over there.
Spread makers.
Okay, yeah. So you do burlesque to the style of Mambo number 5.
No, not Mambo number 5. I'm not beautiful right here.
Oh, okay.
No, I do, like, yeah, I do burlesque. I do have a show once a month in Vegas. That's towards the end of Vegas.
Oh, shit, that's badass.
You really did.
Oh, my God. Diego's going to get up and start doing burlesque.
Can you do the Macarena to this? I don't know. Just
he probably could.
Do it.
Oh, what?
Wait, we said dance, not strip, motherfucker.
Oh, my God.
Emociona.
By the way, this Lou Vega guy, is this dude black or what the fuck?
He's Puerto Rican.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
He's like one of those Latino black.
Okay, so they're the blacks of the fucking Mexican world. Got it. All right, so you get up there and take stuff off, but you don't get completely naked, right?
No, I don't get completely naked. No, the beauty of it, like, yes, you know, it is fun. Yeah, you do get to strip and, you know, and whatever, but I see it as like a work of art, like a mystery. You gotta keep them entertained, you know what I mean?
Badger, you're doing it fucking reverse. You're giving everything away the first 5 seconds and then...
Well, she's the fluffer.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
No, but fluffer means you suck dick, so you're still the fluffer.
No. Fuck you.
Fuck you, Mario. Why you call me out like that?
Telling the truth and shit.
So do you use pasties or electrical tape?
Do you put X's on your nipples?
No, I don't put X's on my nipples.
See, Badger, not everyone does that crazy shit.
I didn't
insane.
Now I heard from other burlesque friends of mine.
What I heard
that,
was
that when you, when they actually put those pastes with the tassels, it's actually an art to get them to fucking
do
you
that helicopter thing.
Oh, you gotta do it, of course, yeah.
Yeah, they said that like
because sometimes they go like that and they're flapping your face.
They're like, fuck.
wait. The titties or the tassels?
Both.
Oh, okay.
It all depends on the size.
Is it kind of like how you spin your hands in different directions?
Yeah.
She could do it. This one was stretching like a mom. You'll be the shittiest burlesque dancer in the world.
He just Andy'd out right now.
Wow.
A one, a two, a three.
That was so like fucking Down syndrome-y shit right there. Oh, dude. Yeah. That was like quirky shit, dude. Straight up.
The ramp.
Now, really quick, I do want to make a special announcement. Andy from the Every So Popular Show, Andy Way You Want It, will be at this year's Long Beach Cyclone.
What?
In denim.
He's he will have a Pigs Radio cut-off denim that was specially made for him.
That's right.
He's flying in on Saturday straight from Vegas to come to this show.
Does he have like Katy Perry and Nicki Minaj and
probably
Lady
it's
Gaga?
All embroidered on him. All embroidered.
It's all his patches.
Now
we should make it. We should make his vest, dude. We should like.
He already has one.
We have one already.
No, we should add to it.
Do we really have one?
Yes. He wore it. He wore it the last time.
Dude, we gotta put the patch. Okay.
He's in all our promo pictures.
Well, we gotta put patches on it. You know, we can't just like let him wear
It has a Pigs Radio patch on the back.
It's gotta have like a fucking.
Has a three-piece patch. We're legit.
What's the movie he's in, dude? Fucking Harry Potter, dude. You know we gotta put like Slytherin and all that shit. We gotta put patches of that shit on there. Dude, we gotta rock that shit out for him.
We'll hit up Underdog, and when he goes to Disneyland, he can pick up all that shit.
Yeah, what's up, Underdog? I know that's Universal Studios.
Pull off over here.
So, anyway, you want it? He's gonna be here live.
I'm excited.
So.
Can I pick him up from the airport?
You can take him with you. You can stay with you. You can do everything.
Yeah, Andy.
So that's gonna be really exciting.
Not for Andy.
Well, probably for Andy.
Oh, he gets to see his girlfriend or his
Marilyn or no?
Marilyn.
Is that her Marilyn?
Is she hosting again?
Yeah, she's hosting again. Emily Marilyn. Yeah, she'll be there.
Does she have a restraining order against Andy?
Probably after this year.
I'm gonna have to disclose. Let her know that. Listen, Andy's coming, and see how she reacts to it.
No means no.
You want like five extra securities and shit? And
she might request it after I let her know. You know, we'll find out.
So he'll let her know the day of.
Yeah. So 2 hours before.
Yeah.
2 weeks after.
Before he
whatever.
Lets you know about the pool party.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Same time.
Yeah. Same time. Totally the same time.
Group text.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So
I'll Snapchat it. There you go.
All right. So female MC, burlesque dancer. What else do you do?
I do modeling, activism.
Naked?
No, not naked. No, I don't do nude.
What?
Semi,
you'll flash your titties with no nipples, but you won't get naked. That's like you're halfway there.
Titties halfway with there, no but nipples. It's still.
Well, it's titties, but just no nipple because they're pasties.
She said no pasties, right? Or you do pasties?
No, do pasties. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I don't do the
stupid
X's.
Badger. Pay attention.
Fuck you,
bitch.
Oh, you whore.
Whore.
Damn, this foreplay.
All right, so what else you got?
I also do hip hop shows and everything. Shout out to Big Duke Street Team and Psycho Realm. Those are my primos right there, a big family right there, always, you know, showing me love and everything. I also work with Legendary Empowerment, which is women empowerment. We work the Chicana Power thing too. They come from Vegas. They're also from Chola Pinup. And let's see what else do I do. Entertain.
Ooh.
I just like to create, you know, creating everything. And the reason I do all a little bit of everything is because I want to motivate people to like stay up and keep doing, you know, the hustle and everything, you know, like it's hard, you know, like how the economy is and everything, just everything put together in that perspective. And I also want to inspire, like, I also do a lot of the female, like Chicana Power and female empowering things is because, you know, I want to inspire women to fucking feel a little bit better about themselves. Not, you know, because if there's a little bit more happiness in this world, you know, be as fucked up as it is. You know?
I want to be happy.
Yeah. So how'd you get into all that?
That is a long list. And then you also like to go to raves.
I do.
So you're like this weird raver, rockabilly, chola rapper.
A little bit of everything. How I got into it is, you know, growing up and seeing different things. Growing up in, you know, in Boyle Heights, that's where I grew up. You know, seeing a lot of different people struggle and everything. And I always wanted to make something better, you know, not just like continue just fucking living the street life and everything. You know what I mean? Sometimes it happens because it happens. You know what I mean? So. I always wanted to do something positive. I was like always a little positive kid. My mom always kind of, you know, been a little positive, you know, single mom and everything. So, right. You know, in order that, and in order for me being like the little nerdy kid, like bully, little fat kid and shit. And I said, you know, to have the mentality and be like, now, like, fuck it, you know, like, I could fucking do it, and I did, and I am, you know? And to other people, like, to keep, you know, keep it up and everything, you know? Like, wow. Yeah.
So, did you ever?
I'm not all hippie status and shit, you know what I mean?
No, I know, you never got into gangs?
Yeah, I did. Well, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, to be honest, so, you know, you, I mean.
Well, who'd you card in with?
Nah, I can't say that.
I don't know what that means.
That. Nah, to be honest with you, I mean, yeah, I grew up in everything. It's, you know, sometimes you just kind of get up in the mix with it and everything because, you know, you see your family, like, you're going to protect them and everything. And either or, you know, you get involved in it. But it's just whether up to you if you want to stay in that life or you don't, you know. You make a better person of yourself or you don't, you know. You know, but still, much love to all of them because, you know what, it's not easy. Sometimes, like, an addiction or everything, it's really hard to get out of, you know? So, yeah.
Wait, so you were really in the gang?
Yes, I was.
They have girl gangs?
What?
Really?
Yeah.
Outside
hey,
of,
they were downer than some of the vatos there, man. I am telling you.
Outside of jail? Yeah. This is a real thing?
You're such a little white boy.
what part of Boyle Heights did you grow up in?
I grew up in Boyle Heights.
What part of Boyle Heights?
I started right there by General Hospital area. Okay. Yeah.
What gangs are out there? Fix, you know? Yeah. Really White Fence, isn't that out there?
Hazard. You got fucking White Fence. You got 18th Street. You got
Are we hit any of them? Familiar?
You got
Get safe.
Now, yeah. did you have a really, like, weird gang name?
Did I have a weird gang name? No.
No.
Can you
no.
give us your gang name? Or?
It's still Casualty.
Casualty.
Yeah. You were like Dreamer?
No, I wasn't a Dreamer.
Little Pantufla.
Big was Dreamer. That your gang name?
Big Dreamer.
No, I kept it as that because I was kind of like undercover chola type of shit.
Like underdog?
No, because nope. I was always into punk, skating, and everything. But, you know, I kicked it with them with Dick. I was the only little weirdo and shit, you know? But, you know, I mean.
Did they ever tell, hey, are you a rocker?
Are you a punker?
K-rocker, dude. I'm just thinking about, I used to be called a K-rocker. Like,
yeah, I can call all sorts of shit. A little Manflora, a little fucking this and that.
Manflora.
Hey, but I handle my shit, you know? I mean, I'm cool.
Hey, as long as you're not a leva.
Not a leva.
You're not a leva, fool.
Wait, what does that mean?
Claro,
leva? It's yeah. Like being a chavala, fool.
What does that mean?
You're a bitch. You're a bitch, dude.
Ah. Okay, I get it.
Yeah, this would be a leva. Yeah. Leva is Mario's fucking pasted right there.
Leva niggas.
I think I would probably be at the bottom of the totem pole, definitely.
You'd be the bottom.
You
would be the bottom.
Exactly. It was all the taxes, fucking financials and shit.
Like, guys, we can make more money if we steal at this time.
We need to diversify the clicas, homie.
You like the 1%.
All right, we're going to take a quick break, listen to some titty songs, and then get some more Pigs Radio tits. Shit. Yeah. It's getting good today. I like it.
Yeah, we need to change this cable. This shit's breaking out, so let's do that.
Shake. Check out the new 4G phones. The Sprint HTC E4 and the Sprint Samsung Epic are here. Both have flash players, so you can stream PX Radio live anywhere in the country. So if you're one of those out there having trouble getting your hands on one of these new, cool, special phones, call Arturo at the Signal Hill Sprint store. He's at 562-225-8443. That's Arturo at 562-225-8443. We welcome all new and existing customers.
Kylo's Pizza, family-owned and operated in Downey since 1964. That's a long time, folks. Kylo's Pizza, where is it? Same place it's always been, 13230 Woodruff Avenue at Foster. Not only do we have great sandwiches, we got awesome pasta specials. But besides that, let me tell you something, folks. We got the best pizza around. You want to know how I know? Because I'm Italian and I love real, authentic Italian pizza. Where are you going to find that? I'll tell you where. Kylo's. No event is too big or too small. We do catering over here. That's That's what I'm talking about. We cook all the food. You eat all the food. You're going to love it. Let me tell you something. We also got delivery. You're at home. You're watching the playoffs. You don't want to leave the couch. Give Carlos a call. We're going to come over there and bring you some pizza at 562-803-6753. Oof, Maron. Well, our pizza is the best pizza in town. We got all kinds of sizes from little itty bitty all the way to a party size. It's almost 2 feet long. Maron, I'm talking about 2 feet long. That's a bigger pizza. You know what I'm saying? 562-803-6753. Carlos Pizza. Or we make a pizza you can't refuse.
Hey guys, if you want to step your game up, go to LibbyGrow.com now for your free sample of the best natural sexual enhancement product available. Find out why millions of men choose LibbyGrow when they want the fun to last and last. No order to place, no club to join, just a free sample. Go to LibbyGrow.com now to get your free sample. Not because you need it, because you want it.
In case you guys don't know, we're chicks. And we love listening to Pigs Radio.
Welcome to Pigs Radio. It is that time, Sunday. Everyone likes different things, and we think that's okay. But this is what we like right now, so sit down and shut your mouth. Because it's time for us to share what Pigs is all about.
Everyone's favorite sing-along song.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Every Sunday we all know you don't do shit home. So
smoke your bowl and drink a beer. Pigs Radio is here. Pigs. Whoa. Fuck Jose, because he doesn't like his song.
You know what?
Pigs. Whoa. Pigs Radio is queer.
I thought since it's been a while since I've been here that I would like be like cool with everything, but no, I still hate this song. So fucking can't stand it.
Pigs Radio. Here. Now we're queer. Pigs Radio episode 186.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn, I should have came tomorrow.
What's up with 200 though?
We're almost there, guys.
When is 200 projected?
Probably like another year.
Probably. I don't know. We have to do something big. We did the Vex that 1 year. And we
start
had
planning it.
We're still planning it?
We'll start planning
200?
It.
200, yeah. You're good with that.
We also have to start planning fucking the Pigtastrophe 6 annual.
We do.
Wait, what if 200? No. That'd be like.
Like, how much?
Probably like in November, no?
No.
At the rate we're
now you're starting, like, starting to sound like the Cholo here. Fuck.
It's in November, que no,
huh? I know, huh?
Yo, Sleepy's gonna be there, right?
I know, huh?
Yo, and Woody and Chuko and. Well, you know.
Wait, there's Choco.
It's big, tiny, little, tiny.
There you go.
All right, so I had Underdog come down today because I heard there was going to be a rapper. Now,
yeah.
I thought it would be fun if you guys battled each other on a rap. Yeah. Open mic.
Go, son. I'll be your hype man. Come on, Underdog.
Hey, I'm down.
Now,
Jungle Beat.
Now, let me tell you about Underdog's rapping.
he doesn't rap. I've tried.
It's so bad that it hurts, but it's so funny that it hurts.
Yo, it's flow, go, ho-oh.
Thundercats,
and ho. And that's probably the best he's ever said
that's
in his
three
life.
Words. That's three words that he fucking rhymes.
I'm still building my blocks, too. You know, it takes a while.
So, I don't know. I'll give you guys a few minutes, and we'll come back. But
I thought I was going to get my ass beat or something.
Because I called him, like, hey, dude, make sure you're there today. Don't be at Disneyland waiting for the fucking new Star Wars thing to open up for fucking 5 years. I need you there. Like, okay, but why?
No tram rides for you.
Yeah. Like, you should, like, the shit that was going through my head that was going to happen, like.
That was a pig's mind fuck.
Yeah, like, I was like, yeah, you're not a bitch. You do whatever they tell you to do.
Like, you're not down. Like, I'm down. Like, I need you to battle someone to the death. Like, okay, I'm down. Like, stupid.
I started, like, working out after that. Like,
started pumping iron at work. Like,
okay, Rocky, like, holding a log. Trying like, to up a snow mountain. No, no,
no. Trying to get his swole on and shit.
The thing is, he really did that.
I'm in my head, I'm imagining this fucking
pouring concrete into
hairy, woolly mammoth of a fucking beast running upstairs with a piece of log. Like,
it's on a twig.
He was making his own weights and shit. Oh. Pouring concrete into like fucking buckets and shit. Fucking putting pipes in it so he could make like fucking homie fucking barbells and shit.
Like, I was chopping wood like shirtless and shit, you know. With some jeans on. Shout out to Von's Badville.
Did you go buy denim to work out in?
I did, dude. I got some special.
Yeah, some denim sweats.
Some denim tights.
Denim workout clothes.
some denim yoga pants.
Extra stretch.
There's nothing you can't do with denim.
Fucking denim.
Dude, that shit got me. Fucking denim fucking stretchy pants. Jeggings? Jeggings, I think they're called.
You think?
I had a fucking jean sweat towel. Sweat towel shit. Fucking on my face.
Denim towel.
Fucking like sandpaper and shit.
Denim bandana. denim G-strings.
denim boxers.
That's got a fucking chafe right there.
My fucking
denim condoms.
My punching bag was fucking all denim.
He's losing his shit.
He really is.
Fucking sweet bag. Socking a bed.
So yeah, so I gave him the illusion that he was gonna fight someone, but it was gonna be a rap battle.
Right.
Now, do you have?
Go.
That's
you,
what I wasn't you, prepared for.
Now, do you have any stuff online that we can go check you out? And
actually, I do. I have Facebook. Like the single out called Libra Scales, and it's you can find that shit on SoundCloud at LA Casualty 420.
Damn.
Do you have a Facebook that people can follow you on?
Instagram,
yeah. Snapchat.
Instagram, LA Casualty 420, and Snapchat Casualty Star. But get ready for a lot of mamadas and pendejadas. So that's all.
Badger, do you need me to translate? You're good on that.
Mario.
She's fucked enough Mexicans to understand what the fuck that means.
Button. I've earned my
it's like, I heard mamadas. It's like, I know what mamadas are.
Every Monday, I do a thing called Mamadas Monday, so I put the most stupidest shit ever on Monday, so people expect that, and it makes them laugh, you know, to enable to make them laugh for that one moment, because you don't know what they're going through, you know.
Wait, so what you post stuff up, like,
yeah,
pictures?
Yeah, every Monday, or every day, I post something stupid, but usually for Mondays, is Mamadas Monday, meaning, like, Stupidity Monday, you know. Oh,
there you go,
not
thanks.
Blue Monday.
She hit the sap button. All right, so wait, what track do you have on there? Because you actually have a few different tracks on here.
No, mine is called Libra Scales, and it's produced at Devil's Playground by one of my boys here, Disciples of the Zik, Tess Lokes. And yeah, that's pretty much what I have out for now. And then I have a sampler of my Spanish rapping, which is actually my first time trying, and it's a freestyle. So
guess what? I got the SoundCloud here. We can check that shit out really quick.
Let's check it out before we get going.
I heard sampler and got hungry.
I bet.
That's Libra Scales, and we're currently working on the video too. I might be your best friend, but your worst enemy. Yeah, I'm Madam Casualty. Yeah. Tears in my pillow, pain in my heart, caused by you. Fuck you, I'll tear you apart. You thought that it was gonna be hard to leave you alone, but I'm crazy to come, crazy to go. And one thing you didn't even know, my heart's empty, runs on empty. Revenge is better served than cold. I'm fucked up in the head, I'm a true psycho soul. Strap me up in a straitjacket, you pussy little whip maggot. Victim, I self-pity, you ain't no soldier, you're addicted to maggots. Sick and vicious, so delicious, hood star, so ambitious. All these bitches, no competition, drop that bass, sit bitch. I'm coke the fuck out, loke the fuck out. I ride that shit, you knock the fuck out. If you ain't with my money, see that door and peace the fuck out. Piss me off once, please, I dare you. My eyes, the reflection of my soul, it scares you. I raise the fire in my kingdom, your body a blessing. I'm the one enriched by evil that the streets aware you. You're falling in my evil spell, my spindle, I pricked you. Your blood, I devour it, and your fear, I gave you. Passion as it turned to fire, your soul I once desired. The essence of your being, I kept once for ten, I once admired. You piece of shit, you little bitch, dirty fucking liar. So intense and nasty like my weed, it got me high. Grab my hips, grab my tits, hurt me so good, bite my lips. I'll teach you all the dirty tricks, like a junkie feeding for a fix. Left you with so what I mean, riding on no other dick. Kiss me up to your fingertips, run me down, you make me sick. What was that? Some other shit. Come on, babe, just let me hit. It's a thin line between love and tomatoes, hate, and that's just it. Raise my bottle, kill the sorrow, left her empty, cold and hollow. Even like my pride, like your dick, I deeply saw a fucking thief. You stolen what I never let you borrow, but it is what it is, and your death is as followed. Insanity and love go hand in hand. As for love, the fiend that'll drive you mad.
I'll pierce your neck while I deadly kiss you. Look in your eyes and I slowly kill you. Cut your throat, your own blood joker. It's your fault, me, you provoke. Let you croak, I artichoke. Silly me, you're a joke. Light my blunt and take a token. In your face, up and smoke. Torture you, your fucking life. You'll beg for me to take it. But every lie should be a toast smash to the floor. Whoops, I nailed it. This was never promised. Jesus selfishly envisioned. Fulfill completed mission. Proceed, incision. It's not another girly story. It's karma as in tales. We're two of a kind, motherfucker. Libra scales.
Damn. Not gonna lie, that was pretty fucking gangster. You know that thing that I do every single time I get a new song, and I go to the shower and I cry and I masturbate? That's the song I'm gonna do it to it. But
what the fuck, Mario? Mario's hitting tracks.
No, that's actually another track I got featured in by this. He's actually a European producer. He's here local in Hollywood, and he wanted to do a dance track, and I said, "Fuck it, let's go." You know. So I'm pretty open. I do tracks for every kind of different type of music. You know what I mean? So
but rapping is your top thing that you rather
that
do?
That I rather do?
Yeah.
To be honest, no, I rather do punk. But
really?
Yeah.
You have any punk tracks?
Nah, not no more. That was like when I was like 14. When I was young.
Chola doing chola is kind of weird. It kind of like throws it off if it's not natural.
It's like two negatives equal positive?
Exactly. But in this case, it's a double negative, not a positive.
I think I need a calculator for this shit.
Dude, if you're Asian and you can solve this math problem, call in at 909-475-7449. Fuck you, Chinks, but you make good Korean barbecue.
What's up?
Mm. You don't make it, dick. They don't make it. You make it.
I know. I want to go pay shit. Them cook my own damn food. I don't need
exactly.
to cook
at home. This motherfucker said, let's go eat. All right, cool. I'm down. And then I got to grill my own shit. I could have been at home.
Okay.
I could have been at home cooking my own
First
shit.
First of all,
that's
he didn't cook.
Intense.
I cooked it. So.
But when you took off, I was there like, what the fuck am I doing here, man?
But we were done already. I went to the bathroom.
I was like looking at the people next to me, fucking trying to see what the fuck they're doing. Hey, look here, Lang Pal.
So wait. Do you wish there was a spot where you could take your own meat and they could grill it for you?
That's
a business right there.
That's a business.
Let me get in that fix.
Okay, so do you want to explain this really quick, Fix? Why this?
Is this a brainchild? Hold on.
Okay,
I need to call Brando. Fucking,
No denim here. No denim.
Right, so what had happened the other day? I went to the store and I saw these beautiful fucking T-bones.
Right.
I said, fuck it. You know what? I'm going to get some of these. But here's my problem. I don't like to grill. I'm not a grill guy.
Okay. Really? So you're a faggot. I can cook.
I was going to say, I don't know what guy doesn't like to grill.
Faggot.
Apparently, this is one.
I don't like to grill.
Oh, my God. I got to cook my own meat. What the fuck?
But I like, a fucking good cooked steak, right? So, anyways, that's.
I'm sure you live at your mom's. Your mom can fry it up for you.
I don't live like my mom.
Okay.
She lives on the outskirts.
Hey, she's my fucking roommate, all right?
That was like
I can't talk to her when she has dates over, okay?
If I see the sock on the door, it's over. So anyways, I was out there with my roommate, and they were cooking up the steaks.
Did you?
I got a little high, and I was a little drunk.
Allegedly.
Just a wee bit.
Yeah. So then I got to thinking, okay, when you go to a restaurant, you're like fucking, and I want a steak, I got to be like, kind of fucking steak.
Yeah, what kind are they gonna bring? It's all full of fucking grizzle and shit.
Yeah. They're like synchronized right now. Like,
so, hey, listen, so I'm buying into this shit. I might become an investor here. You know what I mean?
So my thought was,
I might want to diversify. I mean,
bring your
tea. You know what I mean? She might want to jump in too.
So this is my idea.
So
my idea was, you get the restaurant, right, and then you provide all the fucking sides and everything, drinks and whatever.
Right.
But you bring your own meat, and then we grill it for you right there. So you don't have to worry about cooking sides.
So you
that's
don't
a great
grill
idea.
It.
That's a great idea.
Let me get this straight.
No,
you don't like grilling,
but
you want to open a spot so you can grill other people's meat.
No. I'm going to hire some niggas to grill other
some
people's
meat.
Know
what? Yeah, I don't know if I want to take my meat. Now that I think about it, I said, wait, listen.
Badger painted it a certain way where I'm like, really? Do I want to take my meat to a nigga that doesn't want to cook it?
It's not just the cut. Like, it's how they grill it also.
No, but it would be like something like Benihana's where they grill it in front of you.
But what about the size? Am I got to bring my own fucking, like, Orville fucking bucket of fucking...
He said he provides the size.
No. I provide all the sizes.
The macaroni,
you
got potato salad.
You just bring me your
fucking... Got the mac and cheese and all?
The whole fucking works, bro.
Spread it out.
Spread it out. You get to pick whatever fucking size you want, and then you just bring me whatever fucking beautiful piece of meat that you decide to
right.
get.
Right.
Yeah. He's got a meat complex.
So if I chop up like a bovine in my backyard and I don't want to cook it.
What if I want a cat? Like, would you take cat?
Ooh.
I think he would.
Taco de nalga.
He's not going to discriminate.
Let's pretend I'm Korean and I want to bring in a dog. You know what I mean? It's like, can I bring a pooch in and shit, you know?
As long as that motherfucker got that service sign on him, I don't give a fuck.
All right. Well, that's what I'm saying. Same, man. Wow. See, we can't discriminate in our new business venture.
So it's official. It's official for this year's Cyclone. Bring your own meat, and we're going to have someone cook it for you with all the trimmings.
Yeah, dude, no questions asked.
Listen.
That's going to be at the pool party.
There is a grill charge. There is a grill charge. Right, Fix? We're grill charging?
All I'm saying, bro, is that you're going to be paying for the size and the drinks and shit like that, you know? And
you're going to be paying for the meat, too.
Right. No, but it's going to be your meat, whatever fucking... Like,
you have to pay for the service, not for the meat.
Do you charge per pound? Or?
They're still paying for
it. No, just whatever the fuck you bring.
I know Ben's getting all excited for
servicing. The health department is shutting your ass down.
So
I'm buying the fucking
health
department.
So make sure you bring your fucking roadkill, you know,
your human.
We do possums.
How far is too far? Unicorn?
I don't know.
You never eat a fucking unicorn. That is too far.
Fucking Cecil, or what's the fucking tiger?
Liger?
Let's say the dentist brings in Cecil. You know, would you grill Cecil?
I'd fucking grill that motherfucker.
Grill the fuck
right
out
up.
Of Cecil, homie.
I will grill the fuck out of Cecil.
Make some Cecil steaks. Some fucking Cecil chops, nigga. You know what I mean? Got some Cecil
ribs.
Smoke ribs and shit with some slaw and shit. Some Cecil slaw.
Some Cecil.
Ground beef burger. You got fucking Cecil fucking burger.
Cecil lengua. Cecil lettuce.
He beat up the Cecil. You know what I mean?
Fucking Ciso carnita, Ciso chicharrón,
puro pinche Ciso buche,
right?
Shit.
All that shit.
Oh, that's pretty funny. Dollars for holler.
2-for-1
so
Ciso
this
kimchi Ciso, you know, we got the Korean people.
You would never get past fucking FDA or anything. This is a good idea. Maybe in your backyard with your roommate. Maybe she can spot you after she puts her sock back on.
Hey, Ma, what are you doing in there? What are you doing in there?
Ama.
I got some meat going. Let me call you back.
How come that's not Dad?
Ama, porque está gritando. All
right.
¿Alguien le está pegando, Ama?
¿Por qué estás llorando?
Mami. Ma.
Ma, mami. No grite.
Ma.
No grite.
Cállese, cabrón. Váyase para allá.
Mexicans in the building. Mexicans. Yeah.
Did
all right.
A doorbell? Do we have a mystery guest?
Yeah, it's the fucking FDA going to shut us down and shit over this whole Cecil
that's
talk.
Weird, right? That's weird. I was like, oh shit, hey, it's mail time.
I would eat Cecil.
Oh shit.
Low key though.
Fuck you.
Fuck this dude.
Mario, just in case we are in Compton, right?
Is that too far? Who was that? Was that Ding Dong Ditch?
Yeah, do they not know what time it is? Door knocking niggas and shit. All right, so we gave you guys some time. Are you guys ready to battle live on Pigs Radio?
Battle.
Yeah.
Battle?
Just shoot me a rattle.
No, wait.
I haven't even started.
Wait, do you have a beat?
I just heard a knock. You got to drop a beat, though.
Play some Mama Number 5.
I mean, I could try to beatbox and shit, but I'm not good at that shit.
All right, hold on.
Wait, who goes first?
Yeah, I can't do that shit.
Hold on.
Oh shit!
You want me to go first? You
Kanye
go first?
West production.
First.
Shout out to the homie Jesus.
You want me to be your fucking hype dude? I'll be your hype man.
It's a hype me up, man.
Oh, I'll be like Nathan. Ooh wee.
Let's get this beat drop. Fuck niggas, fuck bitches. I throw this rhyme down. What?
What
is a time now? Oh, I just go with the flow. Where the hoes at?
They
want some fluffy Joes, yo.
Yeah.
Turn me that meat.
Good.
Some barbecue sauce.
So tasty.
You want your grilled meat? Hit
it's
the fix
awesome.
Up.
He'll take care of that meat. Yo,
it's so beefy.
You want cat? You want other?
Yeah.
That sea salt tastes tender.
Like a lion. Be roaring.
All right.
I be pouring and snoring.
Imaginary drop. All right.
That was intense. I'm not going to lie.
Hey, that was pretty good, right? That was in the zone.
That was pretty fucking horrible.
I felt that rhyme when I heard Sessos. Like, that made it for me. All right.
Holy
shit. What'd you think, Gouser T? Do you want to do that same beat or should I find something else?
Well, surprise me.
Oh, I don't know what that means. I'm afraid of getting stabbed now.
Hi.
Don't get shot. Saca el filero, chuco.
Kush and money instrument.
Oh, shit.
I think that's appropriate.
Here we go.
She's at the home field advantage right here. Like, she gets her own track?
you just had your own track.
All right.
Yeah, this sounds pretty gangster right here.
Just getting serious.
I can't hear the snare.
Turn me up. In
Wait for it. It's coming, stupid.
Wait for the bass drop.
Turn me up in the headphone.
Yeah. Madam casualty up in this motherfucker. What are you laughing for, fool? We're going to get serious in here. Pigs Radio. Drop the beat.
I can't even with you, Dick. I'm trying to be serious.
Sorry. It should have been dropped right there.
I know. What the fuck? Stupid black people and their non-making beat abilities.
Oh, there we go.
Got you sick, fucks, twisted. Blinded at sight, but you play submissive. Sad cruelty, and that happens every day. And I see it all day, and it's a fucked up thing to say. But streets are covered with bad habits. Controversy, propaganda, lipstick addicts. Sending in Jordan to watch a show, cause motherfucker, I'm gonna let you know. When I'm done with you, you'll be left a carnivore. Yeah. We're criminalizing the vividly insane. Yeah. Victimizing the criminally insane. We're victimizing the criminally insane. Criminally insane, criminally insane. Barrel to my head now, blow my rain. Time releases in some hypothetical. Dreams are synthetic. Oblivious the truth is all mathematical. Tilting the questions that even don't matter. You look at the Jesus and you look in your heart. You're wondering why, you're wondering why. But the only thing that's left is because you that let your mother die.
What's up? I think Diego won. No, I'm just kidding.
All right.
I want my taco load up.
What the fuck?
All right. I think she been brought it. All right.
They just Cecil'd underdog. You know what I mean?
To be honest, I'd rather have my ass beat right now.
He's had his head chopped off and he's honking a fucking in a dentist office somewhere right now. Dude.
Palo. Palo.
Yeah, dude. That shit was
fucking brutal.
Awesome. She just ruined my rap career.
That was fucking awesome.
You just shut me down. There goes my old dreams.
It's okay. You could dream. I mean, if Nicki Minaj did it, you could too.
Oh, shit.
Nicki Minaj got booty, though.
Hashtag big dreamer. Cholo
name. Dreamer.
You wouldn't make it as a cholo.
What?
I said, this year, you know what the costume of the year is going to be this year. Everybody's going to be NWA and shit. So you're that or El Chapo.
Blackface is always funny to me. That's never going to go out of style. Just saying, it's blackface is the way to go. We should all do blackface, guys.
Blackface is chubby waist.
All, well, you know, never mind, Fix. You're really fucking black. But everyone else, you can do whiteface. You can be a clown, I guess. Whatever.
I love clowns.
You can be a clown.
You can be Gabriel Iglesias this year. How about that?
Really? Why that guy?
What the fuck?
Now, I don't know.
I've never seen him do that in my life.
God damn.
He does that shit, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. So fucking weird.
Just don't call attention to yourself. You already lost a rap battle really bad. Damn, that was really fucking good. We're going to cut that up and sell it and not let you know about it.
Yeah, totally.
So but you're part of the Pigs Radio soundtrack.
iTunes, 99 cent. Can you make it a promo?
We can make it a promo, I guess. I don't know.
Can you make it my background music?
Do you want it as a ringtone? I'm not going to make yours.
I want it as a fucking ringtone.
Especially when she said your mother died. Like, fuck. Dude. Yes, my mom already dead. Fuck.
That's the thing. Like, a lot of people, like they all these girl rappers, bubblegum rappers. Yeah, they're fun, the beats, but, like, sometimes those beats are a waste. It's like, fuck. Why? Truffle butter? Is that what these kids are fucking, you know?
Oh, my God. So that's a very important topic that she brought up, and I just want to touch it because
like
Badger, you know.
Is truffle butter?
Okay, so really quick, for the naive people like me from a month ago, can you explain what truffle butter is?
Truffle butter is, let's see, keep it PG or X-rated?
No, please. Pigs, motherfucking radio.
Yeah. Yeah. But it'll be sensitive for some people's ears.
Don't worry about Badger.
Fuck those sensitive.
Truffle bitches. Butter's been in her ear. Oh. Don't even worry about it.
She has a whole fucking, like,
she's candy.
There's a fridge full of truffle butter. You know what I mean?
She has the truffle of butters right now in her
truffle
fucking
butter.
Hair.
Yeah. Truffle-ist.
Truffle butter creeps?
All right, so explain to us what truffle butter is.
According to my little cousins and shit, like,
oh, don't lie.
It's pretty much another word for chili dogging. That's what it is.
No.
That little
no.
cream, except without the shit, it's like the little cream that comes out. That's what they told me. And I was like, oh, really? That's
what's a chili dog? Because I know chili dog is something.
Chili dog. Chili dog is when you fucking take a shit on a girl's tits and you titty fuck her. That's a chili
that's
dog.
That's a chili dog to me. Shout out to Wiener Schnitzel.
Not that kind of chili dog.
Dude, 5 for 5 special.
Now when I drive by a Wiener Schnitzel, I'm going to be so fucking gross. I'm already gross as is, you know what I mean? That's going to be
this guy
worse.
Enjoys, this guy's fucking Count Chocula over here fucking sucking period blood out of vaginas and shit.
Dick, hey, listen, I need to wear my Red Wings, dude. That's all it was.
Hey, I don't know a single guy that hasn't earned his Red Wings.
That motherfucker right mine. There at the end of the fucking table.
That's gross, guys. It's really gross.
You are so fucking gross. Anglo, dude. You're a fucking wasp, dude.
A wasp.
You're a fucking wasp. You go to Mexico to go. You can spend thousands of dollars to go anywhere, and you go to fucking Mexico, dude. What the fuck is wrong with you, man? That's what white people do.
Badger's onto something.
Hey, I went to real places. I don't know.
I went to real places.
Where'd you go, Badger?
She went to Redlands.
That is pretty real.
But I mean, listen, me as a Mexican, if I want to go visit somewhere, I'm going to go to fucking Europe or fucking Hawaii or some shit. You know what I mean? That's domestic. This right. nigga goes to fucking Mexico. What the
dude,
fuck?
I've never
you're
been.
From there? Well, okay, you're not really from there, but.
No.
You know what I mean? It's like,
I'm born in East LA. I think that's closest, right?
That's pretty fucking close.
All
right. Yeah, you're right by a King Taco. So
I'm surprised I didn't join a gang as soon as I was born in East LA at that time.
Right.
I'm surprised, too.
But yeah, you're a fucking
I'm not surprised.
Because you don't have your Red Wings. Cholo, bro. You would not be a good cholo.
Really?
Yeah.
You would be courted out before you get courted in, fool. That way.
He's like the guy behind the scenes, though.
Maybe I'm like super kingpin. I took over everything.
He's like the smart cholo and shit.
Yeah, like
the fucking the guy that
wants to do calculus.
The guy fucking what's that movie called? Stand and Deliver and shit.
He's the one that wants to do calculus.
The one that wants to learn how to do math and shit. The fucking everything's almost. Anyways,
fucking Lou Diamond Phillips. That's it.
You're Lou Diamond Phillips. You're that motherfucker's a Filipino playing a fucking cholo. So you're not even that, dude.
Ace. Filipino?
Hey, you know what?
Yeah,
he did Richie, bro.
Richie from La Bamba. Yeah, he's a Filipino. Yeah. He's a Filipino, dude.
A Filipino.
Richie! He's from the Philippines. Anyway, so okay, so wait, we didn't really. Okay, truffle butter as well. Isn't that when you like fuck a chick in the ass and you nut in her ass and when it comes out?
No.
That's the truffle
butter? Truffle butter is.
What the fuck?
Like that cum?
You cum in her ass.
The wetness that fucking cultivates.
So
yeah, but you know what? It involves wait, shit. What? It involves shit, right?
A badger. This isn't working.
What are you talking about, Diego?
Look at Mario.
It's almost like milk that like was it congregates or was it
what?
Congregates.
Congregating cum.
What's that word I'm looking for?
What the fuck is it?
It congestifies in your asshole and shit. I don't know what the fuck you're trying to make up words for.
Like the fucking creamy substance of milk.
What?
No. No, okay, I think I thought truffle butter was
pre-cum.
What?
From what? From your asshole?
That thickens. No, from the woman.
That thickens?
No, okay, look it up, dude.
After you stick it in her and you stick it in the ass and that part right there.
That's what I thought truffle butter was more like fucking something that comes out of the ass or what seeps out. Like, say you're fucking a chick in the ass and you nut in her ass, but
no,
you're,
it's not
and then
that.
You pull out,
it's something that'll come out with some shit.
All right,
during penetration.
So, okay, Mario has it. Mario has it.
All right, so I have black friends, and they explained this to me because no one else would. So apparently you're fucking someone, and the froth from everything. Like, you know that one time the badger sucked dick on stage and got all frothy?
Yeah.
So it's frothy with shit and just fucking pre-cum and just everything. Exactly. It's in, and then it starts churning
into
the butter.
It's the wetness. The wetness. Yeah. You know, I used
a new way of churning.
Oh, never mind. I can't go there.
From the wetness and the friction, it creates...
It's like a thing you like travel oil.
Am
like
I right?
Snail trail.
It's not snail trail. It's like a old snail trail.
Badger snail trail.
Well, we don't even want to get into the snail trail.
That's a sounds horrible.
By the way, this year's cyclone will have billions of gallons of snail trail everywhere.
Wait, and truffle butter.
And truffle butter.
Truffle butter is the dick cheese.
We'll be selling truffle butter.
Dick cheese?
It's like dick
Where
cheese
the fuck are you
stable.
Going with this? All right, shut up.
I want to put it on popcorn at a fancy winery.
But truffles are mushrooms. You know that, right?
Yeah, but in this term, it has something to do with things coming out of your butt.
See?
Oh. Whoa.
Yeah.
What? Premio, señor premio. What?
By the way,
boy said, what?
Really quick, the guy who's giving the interview is the most whitest person ever. And of course,
it looks like Mario.
And it does look like me. and it's a chick who's answering this guy.
Gross.
Ew.
Yeah, I know
Quinta.
It's bad. I'm
Ew.
Sorry I added that to this, but I thought it was fair that you know in case you ever came across it.
It's like gross poop.
Wait, is there a different type of poop? Or
what? So I was right.
I thought there was only gross. What's
truffle butter?
What's a good poop like?
All right,
what is not a gross poop?
Who here has anal sex?
Damn.
All right.
I feel left.
Have you ever fucked a chick and when you pull your dick out, shit comes out?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
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 Mario's like, I'll never do it again.
But truffle, I'm telling you what truffle butter is. I know this. Now I'm pretty sure I know this. It's when you fuck you're fucking them in the ass and it's you come, and then when you pull your dick out,
it's
almost like the
it comes out like. It comes out like fucking like they. It looks.
No, it's not like just when it just spills out. This is where it's
like
all the
semen.
All the juices are flowing together.
It's
like
the ass, so
you
though, but
so
it's
you
the
have
ass,
shit
so
mixing up
sperm.
With sweat and pre-cum and all
There's
this.
There's no sweat glands in an asshole. You know what I mean?
Well, your fucking penis in that area is sweating, I'm sure.
Okay, but yeah, but it's everything. All the cumulative comes out and it pours out, and that's what's truffle butter. And it's like shit and semen.
No.
And I guess
if you have, if you're truffling buttering right now, call in at 909-475-7449.
It's almost like the magic bullet.
What? Okay,
yeah,
you watch.
How can you be so far off on everything
this
you
like
say?
It's like a JFK reference.
No, it's like your dick in the ass is
I
like fucks in
enough asses to know when you pull your dick out. Sometimes, not all the times, especially if you come in it. Sometimes shit will come out.
Yep.
It's a mixture of your sperm and feces.
It's a little bit of shit, a little bit of this,
Star Wars
of that. Whatever you got in there.
That's my personal opinion.
You know, I'm going to have to agree with you, bro.
I don't think it's all sweat.
All right. Wait, hold on. Let's see what the whitey has to
say.
Well, there's definitely grosser poops you can have. I feel like the less solid it is, the grosser inherently it is.
Yeah, it looks
Wait,
true.
You know what? That is true.
For lack of a better term, I guess
true.
You could say it kind of looks like diarrhea, but not clumpy, I guess. You know what
like
I mean?
Like soft serve.
Ooh.
It's like, yeah, it pours out like a liquid. It comes out like
it's
a liquid.
Like
old soft serve?
Soft serve, like a beige.
Like soft serve that's been in the machine for at least like 2 weeks.
All right, you know what a cream pie is, right? You know what a cream pie is, right?
Yeah.
That's cream pie is exactly what you're describing when you fucking nut.
Yeah, but this
but
is in
the
ass.
Ass.
Yeah.
That's what cream pie is.
It's not in the ass, dick. It's in the vagina. Yeah. Dude, come on.
I'm an avid porn watcher, and he's right.
Maybe. What is a butt pie then?
I've never
it's
heard
just
of a
delicious
butt
treat.
Pie.
You gotta
that that sounds amazing right now.
Is it specified in what hole it goes in?
No, wait, I'm thinking moon pie. Sorry.
No, okay. I've never heard of a butt pie. So first of all, I think you're fucking.
By the way, are we 5 years old right now? I don't know what's going on. All right, shut the fuck up.
I feel like the elder statesman.
Hey, shut the fuck up.
Well,
let's listen to this dirty Mayata and see what the fuck she says.
I'm more about quality for poops. I don't like to.
Is it like you have sex with somebody in the butt, then like
the mess around it?
Well, needless to say, I was pretty grossed out.
So I ran a quick fact check, and sure enough, oh God, it's even worse than I thought. No, this is a UTI situation. This is a urinary tract infection just waiting to happen. I mean, you're begging for it at this point. Just no, don't do this. No, this is awful. No.
By the way, Badger,
that guy has never had anal sex because he's like fucking saying, don't do it. And I'm like, dude, do it.
Yeah.
Badger, get some cranberry juice right after that shit, it. Dude. Just pour that shit down your gullet.
All
right,
so we actually have the official dictionary term. Badger, I want you to recite this for us.
Go on, Badger. Do it in your white voice. Your white person.
This makes me feel like Jeff, and I'm not down.
Dude, shut the fuck up and goddamn read the fucking thing.
Bitch.
Like travel butter. I don't want to sound like Jeff.
Come on, baby.
Just a tip.
Just a tip.
Just a little. I feel like there's about to be some truffle butter up in this face.
I'm like trying to con you to like fucking me, though.
Come on, girl.
Whoa.
What?
Professing
but
love,
like,
Vegas.
You reciting this fucking.
Just come on. Just definition. Do it for me. Just one time.
Just fucking do it already. Goddamn.
I'm
just
so distracted once. By these sparkles.
All right. Shut up, assholes.
It's just a definition.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
You know I love you, right?
Oh, my God.
You after this.
Butter. All right.
I do it for you.
So. Truffle butter is when you pull your dick out of the asshole and then you continue fucking her pussy, and the tan buttery substance around her pussy is truffle butter.
Really?
See?
Wow.
There is science.
But I've done that. I've never seen truffle butter come out.
That
then,
is not
I guess,
safe,
so.
Y'all.
So,
like
okay, so you're
rules.
Fucking someone in the ass, and then you go straight to your vag, back to the ass, back to the vag.
No, you can't do that. You go from the ass to the vag, and what's coming out of the vag is the truffle butter.
You can't go from the ass to the vag. That's
you never go ass.
Yeah, I have.
That's against, what? Okay,
what if
you
do the shocker?
But
what if you do the shocker?
But that's not truffle butter.
Yeah, that's
but you get truffle butter substance. What if you go two in the pink?
But you're saying two in the stink and one in the pink.
No, but what if you reverse
it? You flip
it.
That's reverse.
Butter.
Because it's normally
by the way, this is the hardest thing.
Trying to do like Cirque du Soleil in the asshole or something? Like, what the fuck?
This was the hardest thing he had to put together tonight. Like, wait a minute. Wait. I have a breakthrough.
I know. No, it's...
All right. Shut the fuck up.
It's got to be secretion. There's got to be secretion.
But I do need to see if the term is legitimate slang. So I met with Jeff Nunberg, a notable linguist and slang enthusiast.
A.K.A.
Truffle butter.
Truffle butter. I don't think you want that word to mean anything more than what it sounds like.
What do you think it sounds like?
It means truffle butter. That's I'm just going to use that randomly. You know, like
but it's a mushroom.
You want to go out to the movie tonight? Truffle butter.
Well, I would advise against it.
Okay.
Do you want to know what it is?
Oh, I haven't.
Right, how's the song go?
I'm actually
melting the truffle butter to pour on the popcorn. I actually came to a close. I was.
All right, I'm over that shit.
That's just like way too much going on right now.
Yeah, that guy really went deep into truffle butter.
Yeah. Yeah. He was just trying to fuck the bitch, and she wasn't down.
Hey, some niggas just have time to do shit, you know?
Wait, what?
Some niggas just have time to do shit.
Oh, okay.
So if you want to look up Truffle Butter, fuck.
Now, apparently there is a song called Truffle Butter out there by Nicki Minaj.
That's the whole point.
That was the point of what?
Yeah. All right. That's where all that came from.
That's not
she's a dirty bitch.
Let's take a break. That's awesome, though.
But don't you think you get like some kind of weird infection in your vagina?
You will.
You get UTI.
So YOLO?
YOLO, nigga. Hell yeah.
What is better?
YOLO.
Momento yo lo saco.
Exactly.
Okay. What is better though?
I love this, bro.
Truffle
I
butter or ass to mouth?
I was just going to say that, but I don't know.
Well, I've done both to chicks.
In the heat of passion, sometimes ass to mouth is accepted.
So do you make out with her after ass to mouth?
God, no.
Mystery
yeah,
nigga?
Yeah, I have.
Yeah?
What if it's in the shower?
But I mean, listen, she's
good, clean fun.
Yeah. Well, yeah, there you go. Yeah. You know, you wash off, right?
I just don't think it's polite to go ass to mouth.
Right?
I don't think that's polite. Badger? You look like you're getting ass to mouth right now.
Come on.
Badger seems so like fucking like virginal right now because all this
she's like, I'm not down with the ass. I ain't married. Mm-mm.
So if you were married, you would be down with the ass?
Yeah. I don't think so.
The booty hole is a sacred hole, fool.
Let me ask you something. Have you ever had a finger in your ass?
What?
No, she's had five at one time.
Okay, so you've had ass play, right? You had ass play.
Like your pinky?
people try to get ass play, and it's like, okay, you just fucking lost out right now.
So that means you didn't like it. So that means why?
No, no, no.
If you're not willing to take a finger in the ass, what makes you think you're going to take a fucking cock in your ass?
When I, if and when I do get married, that means that I love somebody so much that I will give my life to them. Okay?
And but your not asshole?
So wait, your life is your asshole?
You're like that chick from that podcast, eh? The one that said that she'd give up the ass.
Oh, because she's white?
What are those dickheads called?
Oh, that's why?
They don't exist anymore, I don't think, right?
No, they don't. No.
Okay, we broke them up. Fuck you, assholes.
We did.
Ned Files.
Yeah, anyways. Yeah.
Gay.
Yeah.
All right, anyways, so wait. Badger, so you never had ass play ever in your life?
No.
Not even from your dad?
Like, you never fucked with your own ass?
Not. I mean, family doesn't count.
Okay, so she has from her dad. Okay, just make sure.
But that was like
ages ago.
It didn't mean anything?
No.
Okay.
So then you never let anybody do anything back there?
No.
Then you've never had anything back there? No. So you haven't even done yourself in the ass or something? I mean, you know, like.
Oh, yeah. Hold up.
Eat the booty like groceries? Good. No?
What?
Nobody's ate the booty like groceries?
God damn it. You know?
Wow.
I got a Costco card, baby. What's up?
What's up? What's up?
So what's up?
Oh my god! No.
So, gonna check into food for less right now. What's up?
But no fingers, but no tongue action either.
You know they try. Yeah.
They toss and your salad. Come on, you look like the type. You look like the salad tossing.
There's a type.
Yeah, there's a type.
And this falls into it.
Yeah.
You're a complete stereotype.
Your mouth falls into anything. I'm just saying.
What?
Huh?
They're talking about somebody else's.
Oh, okay. I thought we were still making fun of her. Sorry. wasn't paying attention.
You're late, bro.
I know.
Yeah. You checked out.
Shut the fuck up, Manny.
Yeah, exactly. Push the button, Badger.
Shut the fuck up.
All right. We gone over. I'm over the shit.
All right.
LA Casualty, that shit was awesome. Thank you for coming on to the show, hanging out with us. And making Diego look like a fucking giant.
That fucking rap battle was fucking.
We're going to play that shit over.
I got some two upcoming shows with Crazy Race, and you check it out. And come on Characters in Pomona, and check out the page, my Instagram, and all the shows there. You guys are more than welcome.
Yeah.
Dollar Tacos.
Turn up.
Yeah.
So do you have any tips for his raps?
Yeah, don't.
Any tips for his raps?
don't rap, nigga.
She's laughing.
That was my first official rap battle. Was it pretty good?
Well, that was your first and your last. Right. Say that.
If it's the first time, it's always good for first time. You know what I mean?
So it's okay. Did all right, fools. It's like your first
she
fuck.
Said keep your head up.
It's like when you busted your first fuck.
Gotta keep
or your
head
first
up.
Nut.
It's like two pumps.
Yeah, you were a two-pump brother on that rap.
No, I think like you're half. Saying, and that was just half going into it.
Cesar Tijeras that shit.
You know what? Actually, he redeemed himself.
Oh, really?
He did.
Really?
He did.
This
well,
is news. This is breaking news. Yeah. Put on the breaking news music, Mario.
Oh, there it is.
Telemundo. All
right. There you go. At least that. All right. Is this something we want to get into right now? We're already over.
No.
We could just give a little preview.
Okay.
Just a tip.
Let's get into it.
I know is this motherfucker would not stop, and I was just over it. I'm like, I'm done. I got to go to sleep.
So it was a complete opposite of the first time.
When was this? Is this who you've been posting that you've been going to go eat with and all this bullshit? Or
fucking Benihana? Bring your own meat.
Bring your own meat. He brought his own meat?
He did.
He brought his meat to Badgers?
He did.
He fucking pounded that
shit. This was actually about a month ago, probably.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Like, I've been off the show for that long, huh?
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So not like he went. He just full bore.
He
went
just
too
like,
hard.
All right.
Because I was trying to prove
for
a point.
Me, it's not like, oh, do me all night long. It's like, I want you to do me a lot of times really fucking good, but I want to rest in between.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like,
this fool was trying to do
I don't
want to
just keep going.
So
like,
how long did he bone you for? like at least 3 minutes?
What's too much?
Yeah,
dude, it was
anything
like
longer than 50 seconds.
It's the blunt one.
It was like, I mean, fuck, it felt forever.
2 hours?
Was he heavy breathing on you? Like,
yeah.
Who was on top?
I ain't putting in work.
My nigga, right here.
That's why you're single.
Oh shit. Hey,
Maybe he was the one fucking working out in the mountains and shit.
Even, you know, that fool was heavy breathing. He probably fogged up the house. He, like, the way he fogged up the truck, the way he fogged those windows up, he fogged up.
You fucking cross it with a fix right here.
The best I could probably imagine this is like two sea lions fighting over the last dead fish in sight. Like, just bad. Just weird noises, a lot of flappy.
I was like trying to crawl away, like, stop.
So that was Chewie from Star Wars.
Ah, shit. That's fucking awesome. That's fucking awesome. I can't wait to hear the whole fucking story. Yeah. Holy shit.
That was the whole fucking story.
No, we're not going to get into the details.
Wait, so what I want to know is...
I want to know from beginning to end, how did it start? Did you know you were going to do all that shit?
Yeah. But that was just the tip. For
later. Oh, so you were wearing matching underwear?
What?
You were wearing matching underwear then?
The fuck are you talking about? No, fuck no. I don't need to do that. This has been like 2 years going. I don't need to do shit anymore.
It's done. Done deal, fool.
Come on, man. Over.
That was the weirdest thing I could hear anyone ask.
I know, right?
On that note, thanks, Fix, for derailing the show and coming down and hanging out with us. Check out the Long Beach Cyclone. Get your tickets if you haven't. Cheap motherfuckers.
LBCyclone.com.
Ooh.
That's check out. PSYCLONE Cyclone.
What?
That's right.
Scallywag Events, Facebook, Instagram.
Once again, Pigs Red is going to be a closet case that year. We are going to be hanging out at the Mystery Niggas Room.
But I will snail trail bastard all over that bitch.
Don't we're
gonna,
do we, that
we're
shit,
gonna, we're
going
to leave a snail trail to the room.
You only change the sheets in the morning. I don't have to sleep. With,
oh, you don't even have to worry about the sheets. I'm talking about the whole fucking venue. Yeah,
you're fucking damn disgusting. But you know what? I love it. Hey, fuck it. Let's do it.
That's a lot of fucking time to be on your ass just fucking...
Just fucking
like just everywhere,
like a dog fucking running its ass.
You're just gonna see Badger slowly going around in the hall.
Like, imagine what
you're
doing.
Just
like two little steps, like, hey, just, you know, snail trail. Like, all right, cool. Laters.
So disgusting, but I'm turned on. Yeah. All right, let's go, man. Fuck
on that
shit
note, picks out.
Hey, yo, DJ, stop the music! Countdown! 5, 4, 3, 2.
Initiating shutdown sequence. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you, I'm out.
This show may cause birth defects and or cancer. Void where prohibited in the Southern Red States. Official sponsor of the Special Olympics. Not really. 2% financing available for nothing. See your official Toyota dealer for recall as penalty for not buying American. This show may cause massive amounts of marijuana consumption. This show has been a joint venture of cockballs and ass. Free salad tossing available upon request. Visit RobertReese.com. Sexual relations among cousins is not incest.
Thank you.
That will conclude this evening's entertainment.